night. Which is, it doesn't matter. I don't care. Hoot. It's more fun kibitzing with you.
They just think it's not on, but it's actually on.
You know, I could be. I don't think I've sworn so far. Everything I've said is... If it is on, people are probably very entertained. Just in case we are on, this Paul Tardy, coach of the Robillard team. It's getting better. See, if Bottcher had gone with my idea, they wouldn't be in this. His second shot would be unremovable. Yeah. Don't know what they're thinking.
Now you're going to be, put something in front of there and you smash the blues goal and the red doesn't go anywhere, right?
Yeah.
You can leave the blue here in a really bad place. And it doesn't take much. You've got six inches to work with. And if Mark's 6 inches heavy, it's a disaster. He taps it right, frozen.
Sure. It does look a tad heavy. It's going to be a little... No, it's coming down. Ooh, got a nice angle. Oh, come on, Sebastien. Guard it, I dare you. Where is Sturmey out of? Manitoba, Alberta?
Sturmey's out, Edmonton.
Never heard that about curling. Never heard that comment. Test, 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 test.
Yeah.
on in. Technical difficulties. I'm scheduled to be, but I'm waiting for Andrew to tell me that we're live. But not this one. He's having technical difficulties. So the one without commentary is being shown on two. Thank you.
Yeah.
Test.
Thank you.
nights in my book this month. Come on. Thank you. Test.
Testing 1, 2. Morning and welcome, Penticton Nufloors Classic. Opening draw, sheet B. We'll pick up the play here near the end of the fourth end, midway in the game. Team Bottcher leading 4-1 over Team Robillard. Penticton Nufloors, primary sponsor of this match. And today's opening match on Sheet B brought to you by the City of Penticton. Last rock here in end four. Good control. Nice hit and sit for the single. So the pattern is set. First half of the game. Deuces for Team Bottcher. Singles for Team Robillard. 4-2 for Team Bottcher after four ends. Everybody out there should know Team Bottcher, ranked number 2 in the world coming into this event. So Team Robillard, a newly assembled team this year on the BC circuit. Mr. Robillard been curling in BC for a number of years now at a high level. They've had 6 events this year, 2 finals. Made the playoffs in 5 of the 6, so they're having a pretty good year. Alternate Nathan Small in the lineup today, throwing lead rocks. here we go, the back half of game one. Sheet B, Penticton Nufloors Classic 2023. One presumes that the team Robillard will get a bit aggressive now. Try to look for a steal, try and claw their way back. Three sheets going on this opening draw. Sheet C beside us, Hosley and Jones, the local ice maker manager, taking on former world junior competitors, Hosley out of Switzerland. And over on sheet D, Kolomaya versus Sturme. Sturme leading 3-1. And there'll be an update on their score shortly, as they are also in the fifth end, but the fourth end score hasn't not gone up. In theory, the mics, the skips should be mic'd up. I don't hear them. So that may be part of the technical difficulties, which is why we're picking up the commentary here mid-game. Jordan Tardy, second for Team Robillard, drops one in, biting the button. Doesn't get quite the finish they were hoping for, so Team Bottcher will undoubtedly remove this and roll away from the forefoot. If they stay 1-2, Mr. Robillard will start having decisions to make. Does he stay aggressive? Really try and drop a draw in there, or does he work away at removal of the Bottcher team stones? Well, he got a bit of a break because they're not sticking around on this one. And technically they stick around, but they're not 1-2. This allows Mr. Robillard stay aggressive. He needs to drop one in fully buried. Try and get his team back in this game. Second shot, same line. Not getting the curl they're hoping for. See a brief discussion between the skip and the thrower. This time a better shot by Team Bottcher. No, they are lane two. Oh, Mr. Robillard is going to put the game on the line here, folks. He's staying aggressive. He feels, obviously, he needs to score steal here. He's going to ignore the Bottcher team rocks. Playing with fire on ice can sometimes lead to a meltdown. We can see this rock has a bit of a tighter line, has a better opportunity to bury. Sweepers working hard. They got the line better this time. Do they have the weight? They do, just enough to be shot. Not 100% buried. Probably see 3 to 4 inches of that rock from the hack. A foot more weight and they would have been golden. Would have been totally out of sight. Kennedy, third for Team Bottcher. There's the release. Real down weight. Looks to be hack weight. Maybe board. And there you go. You can't show those 3 or 4 inches to teams at this level. Here we go. Fourth time lucky. He has tightened up the ice. The way they're finishing, they do need to be spot on with their weight. So he needs about 2 more feet than he threw last rock. Can they make the adjustment? It does look like it. It does look like it's got a little more weight. However, it's curling early, curling harder. Similar line, one might suspect that rock is a little different than the previous one. Definitely curled harder than any of the 3 previous draws. One starts to think we can hear a singer warming up, female one. Lady sings the blues, perhaps. Okay. There it is. Team Bottcher lane 4. Skips rocks. Yeah, three-team discussion, three-team member discussion. And we'll just keep going with the cliches, in for a penny, in for a pound. But it's not looking good for Team Robillard here. He's going to need two fantastic skip rocks. Ooh. This is out there a bit. Sweepers seem to like it for weight. They're on, they're off. Trying to make it curl. Once again, not quite getting the finish they're expecting. But miracle of miracles, they are shot rock temporarily. Interesting. Mr. Bottcher content with his lead in score, so he's choosing just to draw for one on his first rock here. Even though if he moved that stone just thrown by Robillard, he would be laying five. My guess is he's hoping to bury and then perhaps move that Robillard rock later if opportunity arises. Third last rock of the end on its way. Weight looks good. He's hanging out there, not getting the curl. He's coming in late. Okay, he's a little bit deep. Well, Mr. Robillard can drop a beautiful freeze in there. He could get the steal he was looking for. Fickle game curling. Not many shots made by Team Robillard early, but the skip may be able to save their bacon here. Well, they're discussing. We look at the scores on the other sheets. After five ends, Hosley from Switzerland, five. Team Jones, Penticton, a one. Sturme, five. Kolomaya, two. big shot here, folks. A good shot here can get Team Robillard back in this game. Line looks good. Weight looks good. Sweeper's leaving it be. So we presume it's got more than enough weight. It's curling in nicely now. Comes in. A little bounce. Ooh. Just didn't finish enough. We see big weight Bottcher catch a quarter of that rock and score a potential five. I would say the incentive is there. It would be just as difficult, if not impossible, to score two. So you might as well go for five. Quarter rock or less. There's the broom, that's the call. Has to be. We should see a very fast rock here. Somewhere in the 4 second range. Big weight, straight as an arrow. Catch a quarter rock and shake hands. It's on his way. He's looking pretty good. He's got a piece and goodbye. Good night, Irene, folks. And there it is, the shake of the hands. Well, that was short but sweet, folks. Technical difficulties. We didn't pick up the announcement there, but we did get half an end in. Hope you've enjoyed this coverage. Switch over to sheet C and D, and then come on back for 11:30. Penticton Nufloors Classic 2023. Have a great day. Good curling.
Which didn't help our game, that's for sure. Look at that. You went online and just went in the tank going, what the hell?
I got kicked, so bring it on. If you want to blame me, that's going to weaken your standing in the coaching world. I'll tell you that.
Thank you. the thrower is so on. It's all about the color.
It's on the side of beforehand.
That's right.
Commentary, so just across the west back and forth. I guess you guys this team doesn't have too much outside the province.
No, so it's
keep it local.
Super easy. There's one event in Alberta. And only went and saw Tyler play in Okotoks, so can't chase him around.
Yeah.
The qualifying in two slams in a row by
I watched
LSD there. A couple of centimeters.
They're not looking. I mean, you know, it's so fickle. But they haven't been all looking overly happy. That's why I was glad to see them win this last event, just to get a little.
Yeah.
I don't think people really realize the. The importance of confidence early.
Oh yeah. Chemistry and all
those times when you get in the groove and you just feel it and you know I'm making this, I'm making this. And then when it goes sideways, then that's gone out of the head. And all kinds of different things get in there.
Yeah.
Like, Jesus, when am I gonna make a shot? Right? Right?
That's I used to always make things.
Yeah, yeah. Attitude, confidence. One of the best ever is the father-son duo of Gibson's. Two very good curvers.
Yeah.
Dad always skipped. His son is early 20s, very good curver. So on this particular night, they decided to switch up. And the son is throwing last rocks, calling the game.
Nice.
And I'm over about two or three sheets over, but I hear some stuff, and then I kind of look over. And Dad couldn't help himself. So it skips rocks. It's an important rock. They'd already discussed. He gets down, set. Dad lands it. Don't be tight. Right? Oh, this son just leaps up. You had to fucking say it, didn't you? Can't keep a fucking mouth shot, could you? And I'll ask you, did he make the shot or not? No. Oh, it was so classic. I wish I'd had it on film. You can play it at every seminar you ever did. Right? And he couldn't. He held himself back until he couldn't no more. And he had three more seconds and the rock would have been on its way. But he couldn't. And that, I loved what the kid said. You couldn't. You just couldn't keep it to yourself. I know not to be tight. It's like, I understand the game. You trained me. I'm 24 years old. It's like, how many times do you get...
my first throw, yeah.
Funny. I was telling somebody this year, the one I hate is, I should get myself a decent team to coach, because I hate it when the women do this all the time. Shooter gets in the back and the sweeper. Okay, you got this.
No.
I hate that. You got this. No, I don't got this. I want this. Maybe say that in about 15 seconds, that. Maybe.
Yeah.
As you got it.
Yeah, you can't miss this.
So my theory is everybody talk to each other. What do you want to hear?
Yeah, totally.
Do you want to hear nothing?
Yeah.
That's what we give you.
Yeah.
Do you want me to get pom-poms and be a cheerleader? Yay, Paul, yay, Paul, you can do it, yay, Paul. Very few men are going to do that, but maybe that's what they want, right? Some guys, you're the greatest. And other guys are like, make this fucking shot, right? Give me fucking insult me. It gets my blood flowing. And, right? But everybody's different, but you got this drives me batty.
Oh, yeah.
Because.
Not a good stand that.
Yeah. That good smile, but anyways, go give the boys shit. Yeah. Tell them you got your shoes in the car.